112. Yarron. The people are called in the galaxy of yarn. They make cloths. I got there and it was raining, and I mean raining. It was coming down so fast I just could not see even where anything was. I asked the attendant if it's going to let up soon. He looked at me and said it rains like that once a day that hard, but it only lasts about 20 minutes. I said, wow, so how long has it been? He said about 3 minutes. I said, okay, where I can wait until it is over. Go inside and wait until it stops. I said thanks and went inside and sat and waited for it to stop raining. It did not seem long and it stopped raining and the sun comes out. I said, wow, that was some storm. I went outside and walked to the Wisha Inn and I tried to open the door. It was a lock. I got my key out and it fit and I unlocked the door and went in. Someone said, who are you and how did you get in? I said, my name is Jack Wisha. I own the Wisha Inn and I am here to stay for 2 or 3 days to get ads for the Wisha newspaper. He said, okay, and the room key is in back of the counter. I said, where are you at and who are you? He said, I am in the back room behind the counter and I am busy getting dressed. I will be out in a minute. I said, okay, and went and sat down at one of the tables. He come out and shook my hand and said, it has been a long time since I have had anyone from the main office out here. It is kind of out of the way. I said, yes, it is, and that is why I am here to check up on everything and get some ads. He said, wow, everything is fine here. I said, how come the front door was locked? All Wisha Inns are open 24/7, 7 days a week. He said, we have not had someone that wanted a room for about 2 months now. For some reason, the rates are too high here, and once they find out how much the room is, they leave. I said, we can fix that. How much did they say they wanted to pay per night? He told me and I said, well, they said that much, boy, that is low. But to rent the rooms, you have to do what you have to do. I told him the price we have to get and it was like 5 more than what they said, but that is the lowest we can go per room. He said that is better than the old price anyway. I will put an ad in the paper for tomorrow and see what happens. He said that will work. Okay, I need to go to my room and make some phone calls, and what do you have to eat here? He told me and said that will be fine. I got the key and went to my room and made some calls. Soon he brought my dinner to me and I watched TV for a while and fell asleep, and I was awakened by the phone ringing, and I picked it up and someone said, are you Jack Wisha? I said, yes, I am. He said, I would to place an ad in your paper and could you come by in the morning? I said, yes, I can, and give me your address and phone number. He gave me the info and I said, okay, see you in the morning. I hung up and just went to bed. I got up in the morning and went downstairs and said, anyone here? He said, yup, and what would you like for breakfast? I said, what do you have? He passed me a menu and I said, okay, and ordered. I went over and sat down at one of the tables and waited. Soon he brought it out and I ate. Then I said, where is the place I have to go? And I told him the address and he said, fourth place. On the left down the street. I said, okay. I went out a door and walked down the street and got to the place and I went in. The person behind the counter said, how can I help you? I said, I am Jack Wisha and someone called me from here and wants to see me. The person said, just a minute and I will check. They picked up the phone and made a call. When that person hung up, said, please have a seat and he will be right with you. I said, okay. Just as I sat down, the door opened and he said, Jack, come with me. I got up and went down a long hall, and at the hall we went into a big office and I sat down in front of a desk and he sat down, and then he said, how big of an ad can I put in the newspaper? I said, you can have a whole page if you want one. He said that might work. We need to advertise our products for sale and we need more help to make our products. I said, then how much is your budget for advertising per month? He said whatever it takes and all we need is to run the big ad for a month and then small ones the rest of the time. Okay, we can work something out. You will have to put the ad together and if you can give it to me before I leave. He said, how long do you plan to be here? I said about 2 more days. He said, we will have it done before then. I said thanks and I got up and was just about to leave and he said, how many others are you here for to get ads? I said, I don't know. I thought that while I was here I would make some calls to see if any others would want to put an ad in. He said, there might be a lot of business here that need help and would like to advertise. Business here is good and there is just no help here. I said, well, maybe we can change this for everyone. He said, I hope so. I left and went back to the Wisha Inn and just as soon as I got in the door, the guy said, you've had 10 calls for a lot of business here wanting to put ads in. Here, give me the messages and I will call them in my room. Just as soon as I opened the door, the phone rang. I went over and picked it up and it was one of the companies that had called earlier. I talked to him for a while and then called everyone back and got calls in the meantime. I guess none of the salesmen have ever been here. I will have to keep all the phone numbers and call them all the time. I guess I will have to put a new item on the list of ads in the paper. Jobs on each planet and products for sale. It is time for dinner and I called down and ordered and in no time dinner was served. I watched TV for a while and then went to bed. I woke up to the phone ringing and it was the wife and she said, we have been getting a lot of calls from the business from where you are at and we have been telling them to call the inn. I said, that is good and it has been pretty busy here with all the calls. I will be home tonight on the space bus. There is so much stuff going on here that I want to go home now. She said, just hang in there and it will be over soon enough. I guess you are right. Love you and talk to you later. She said, love you and have fun. I said, I will. Take care. I hung up the phone. I got up to go downstairs to get some breakfast but the phone rang and it was the guy at the desk and he said, breakfast is ready. I said, I will be right down. I got downstairs and sure enough breakfast was ready and I sat down and ate. The phone rang 3 times and I said, have them call back in a half an hour. He said, will do. I finished eating and went back upstairs. Just as I got there the phone rang. It was like that all day and half the afternoon. I got through it and it was time to get on the space bus to go home. Boy, I was ready for this. I walked down to the space bus station and when it arrived I went straight to my room and I laid down and fell asleep. I woke up to a voice saying, we have landed, and I got up and went home. Story done by Jack Wisha.